Adding text to any image has been found to increase understanding and memory retention. So if you want to be super clear about your messaging and have your audience remember what you said for much longer, you need to learn how to add text to video. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how easy it is to do this using my new favorite video editing tool. And if you're a YouTuber, make sure you keep watching because I'm going to show you how to use this video editing tool to create a super simple subscribe button to add to your YouTube videos. Welcome and welcome back to my channel. I'm Nikki Pasquier and I'm here to help you successfully grow your business online using some of the best organic marketing tips and tricks. So if this is something that interests you, be sure to subscribe to my channel, turn on that little bell notification so that you don't miss out on any of my videos. To start off today's tutorial, all you need to do is type this URL into your browsers and open up a free account with Veed. Click on the black sign up button, use an email address or sign in with your Google account. Now tell Veed what you're going to be using it for. Then choose a suitable plan. So from your Veed dashboard, you'll want to begin by uploading your first video. To do that, you can either click on this button here or you can click on this button. And I'm going to do that and then select Create Project. Now I'm going to upload my video snippet from my local device by clicking on this button right here. If you want, you can also drag and drop your video snippet into this portion here. I'm just going to close this down because I've already got a video snippet uploaded. So I'm just going to click on it to open it up. You'll notice that you have a sidebar on the left-hand side with all the lovely editing features where you can add media, audio, subtitles, text, elements and transitions, as well as filters. Underneath you have your video timeline with your video playhead and various editing tools right underneath. So to add your first lot of text overlay to your video, go back to the sidebar and click on text. And you can now select whether to add a title, some regular text or some handwritten text. Or you can use one of these pre-formatted text combinations underneath. I'm going to go back and I'm going to add the first headline to my video by clicking on the headline title, and that brings the text overlay onto my video. You can start editing the text by going over to the left-hand side and adding your title. To edit the text, go underneath and find the text style. You have a pull-down menu here, so click on that and explore some of Veed's fabulous fonts. I think I'm going to stick with Montserrat. You can edit the text further by increasing or decreasing the size, changing the text color, selecting whether to bold the text, add italics. I think I just want to bold my text. You can change the alignment by clicking on these buttons here. So now you can see you've added some simple text overlay to your video. You can edit the text holder by increasing the size. So place your cursor over one of the corner buttons, hold your cursor down and drag it out or back in again. And to change the dimension of the text box, just click one of the sidebars and drag those out. You can change the position of your text overlay by just holding your cursor over the text, hold the cursor down and drag the text into position. Okay, fabulous. So you've just added some simple text overlay to your video. If you go down to your video timeline, you can also see that the text has been placed over the top of the video right here. Right now, I want to make this text stand out against the video. So to do that, I'm going to select the text box again, go back to the left-hand side and click on this little menu that says More Options. There's a downward arrow here, which I'm going to click. And underneath, you have some more text options. So you can adjust the text spacing and the line height. And now to make the text really stand out, I'm going to click on this downward arrow and add a text box. So I can add a block of color behind the text. That's a little bit too much. So going down, I'm going to have a look to see what this background square is like. which is much better, or there's a background rounded, and that's much better, I think. You can also change the colour of the text box by clicking on this little button here and then selecting whichever colour you'd like. But I'm going to stick with black because that really contrasts nicely and makes the text stand out. Okay, so once you've gone through this the first time, you can now go ahead and add some more text. So I'm going to select the video background, go back to the text button on the left-hand side and click it, and now I'm going to add some regular text. I'll walk you through this process again just so that you're absolutely clear on what you need to do. Okay, so now I have my title text and a subtitle on my video, but I don't want them to appear at exactly the same time. So I'm now going to show you how to add text at specific points in your video. To do that, I'm going to go down to the video timeline and select the heading, which is this one here. I want the heading to appear 1 second into my video and finish at 5 seconds. There are two ways you can do this. You can either grab a hold of one of these sidebars with your cursor, still holding your cursor down, drag the sidebar to the right position. So that's 1 second in, and I'll drag the end sidebar to the 5 second mark. Perfect. Now let me show you another way you can do this, which is probably easier. I want to now have the subtitle appear 7 seconds into my video and ending at 10. So with the text selected on my timeline, I'm going to go right up to the top of this column here where I have two stopwatches. This is the start stopwatch and this is the end stopwatch. I'm going to go back down to the video timeline and I'm going to grab a hold of the video playhead and drag it along to the 7 second mark. Then I'm going to go back up to the stopwatch, the start stopwatch, and click on it. And you'll see that my text has moved along to the 7 second mark. I know this doesn't look right at the minute, but bear with me. Now I'm going to drag the video playhead to 10 seconds, which is where I want the subheading to end. And I'm going to go back up to the top and click on the end stopwatch. And that's perfect. And you can see how now my subtitle starts at 7 seconds and finishes at 10. So you can use whichever method you prefer. So let me just play this video back by dragging the timeline back to the start. Let's see what the text looks like. That's my headline text. And that's my subheading. Whoops, I think I'm going to drag this down to the bottom of my video. And that looks much better. Fantastic. And once you've done your text, you can have a little bit of fun by adding perhaps some animation to it. I'm going to click on the text to select it, go to the left-hand side of my desktop, and click on the animation tab. If you don't know what the animations look like, just hover your mouse over the little thumbnail image to get an idea of how the text will appear on your screen. I think I'm going to stick with slide right. So to add the animation to my text, all I need to do is click on the thumbnail. So that is all there is to adding text to a video using Veed. Now let me show you how to easily create that subscribe button for your YouTube videos using Veed. Next time, I'm going to take things a step further by showing you how to easily create subtitles for your videos using Veed. So if you want to learn how to do this, just give me a subtitles in the comments box below. If you want to learn how to use Canva to add text to videos, all you need to do is click on this link here and I will take you through the whole process. If you've not done so already, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you so much for watching and for your time, and I will see you next week.